Although its effects can be measured with precision, nobody knows what gravity is. It is also the only force man cannot yet control. Despite the law it is supposed to follow, it often simply does not. Even here on Earth, let alone further out in space, gravity is full of anomalies. So said Eduardo Cardona, an old world electrical engineer, a towering intellect, major author, and good friend. Globular clusters are a particularly difficult problem for a gravity-only cosmology. According to current understanding of gravitational dynamics, they should not be where we see them, and their spheroidal configuration defies the expectations of standard theory, not to mention that they sometimes form a ring-like crown around the axis on each side of a galactic plane. Quote, a globular cluster is a spheroidal conglomeration of stars. Globular clusters are bound together by gravity with a higher concentration of stars toward their centers. They can contain anywhere from tens of thousands to many millions of member stars. The origin of globular clusters and their role in galactic evolution are unclear. End quote. Today, cosmologists continue to wrestle with problems posed by exotic structures in space. These appear to mock Newton's elementary laws. In their attempt to account for unexpected galactic motions, astrophysicists have invoked invisible entities and agencies, black holes, dark matter, and dark energy, which are imagined to be far more powerful than anything actually observed. In stepping out on this lily pad, they have even speculated that as much as 99% of the matter in the universe is dark and can be measured only by apparent gravitational effects. Because dark matter and dark energy can't be detected, they are a reusable blank check. A blank check that conventional theorists can use to postpone the bankruptcy of a thoroughly falsified paradigm. It was this resort to unknown matter that caused the notable astronomer Halt Narp to observe in his book Seeing Red that, quote, past 90%, it begins to make observations irrelevant, end quote. You think? I would posit that past 50% or less would be a more realistic intellectual barrier. ARP, please don't tell me the emperor is naked. In stark plain language, astronomers and astrophysicists that believe this should stop taking money from public institutions and get a real job making some valid contribution to society. Flipping burgers would be a major upgrade in terms of service to mankind. With our own galaxy, the Milky Way, globular clusters or spheroidal configurations of stars such as M15 are included as a part of the difficulty. By what mechanical magic does gravity hold millions of stars together as a sphere rather than the familiar disk of more feasible gravitational orbits and models? Gravitationally spherical configurations of stars simply hanging in space are absurd. Orbits around a center of mass just don't work either for globular clusters. There would be orbital chaos. Think about it. The problem is heightened by the fact that M15 is one of about 150 known globular clusters associated with the Milky Way. Strictly speaking, they are not a part of our galaxy as traditionally defined. Rather, they appear close to the core of the galaxy as a kind of halo above and below the center plane of galactic rotation. Yet, astrophysicists rarely acknowledge the dynamical problems this creates. Theory states that clusters above the plane must move on orbital paths around the center of the dynamic system as a whole. And in completing an orbit, each will intersect the galactic plane twice. Such orbits for a three-dimensional structure would have orbits crisscrossing and even in reverse. There would be numerous flyby interactions that would induce tidal distortions and disrupt the cluster. Of course, another concern is that the structure of the halo could neither be formed nor maintained. The problem was noted by physicist C. Johnson of the University of Chicago. Quote, "It is almost like physicists have been assuming globular clusters just hover there like a swarm of bees, but that wouldn't happen. They could not just follow elliptical orbits above or below the galactic plane. Basic gravitational theory insists that their elliptical paths pass through the galactic plane because the two halves of any path must be on opposite sides of that plane." End quote. Johnson suggests that something is missing, and not a small piece of the puzzle. Quote, "It would appear that either our understanding of the laws of physics is sadly lacking, or our understanding of the geometry of the situation is greatly in error. The commonly accepted view of a halo of ancient stable globular clusters hovering around the core of the galaxy like a swarm of bees is just not something compatible with our current understanding of the laws of physics. Clearly, further research is necessary." End quote. And thereby, Johnson illustrates the real problem. It is not more research that is needed, but an open-minded paradigm shift to electric universe construction. But heaven save us from that. Anything but that. Apparently, the favorite prayer of astrophysicists would be, quote, "Dear God, please don't bring a paradigm shift during my tenure." The solution, of course, is that galaxies are electrical structures whereby the various components revolve around the minor axis, never crossing the central plane. The same quandary applies to the relative motions of stars within each cluster. And while Johnson accurately describes the gravitational dynamic, the rule he applies is a formula for chaos. As any gravitational simulation will clearly demonstrate, it would quickly lead to some stars being accelerated out of the system, while others would lose energy and fall to an orbit closer in. Over time, the globular clusters would largely just evaporate, shrink, and condense down to what? But from the electric universe vantage point, it is not unthinkable that the stars of globular clusters are just hanging there, with respect to the cluster's own center of gravity and any cluster plane that may be derived or defined. In the electric universe model of stellar composition and energy, stars are concentrations of highly positively charged material. For globular clusters, such a collection of stars with no other external distorting forces in play might indeed become a stable ball of stars formation. In fact, the new view of the universe provides many examples of star-sized masses, even galactic clusters, in symmetrical arrangements that gravitational theorists never dreamt of, including polar alignments. And as for the spheroidal form of globular clusters, the cosmic electricians in the electric universe paradigm suggest that the best analogy may come from something as unfamiliar to astronomers as ball lightning. whatever enigmatic material that is composed of. But that is a different anomaly subject. I offer another analogy. Mainstream cosmologists are playing in a children's sandbox instead of on the beach. Our ponderous university and tenure system is suffering from all but paralyzing arthritic inertia. I know. I have talked with some of them, and they say they teach what they have been taught and cannot teach what they haven't learned or don't know. I suggest, given the past track record of institutionalized science, this may border on being a cop-out and being intellectually irresponsible. There is no independent global agency that is looking at the big picture and alerting the university science departments that, given the nature and history of scientific revolutions, which are always vigorously opposed and overdue, it is time to consider a paradigm change, time to explore alternate thinking, and seek and invite serious challengers to present their arguments. Usually, any one professor that might raise the alarm gets marginalized, just like a heretic in a religious organization. Halt and Arp certainly suffered this fate. Of course, institutional science is a religion, just organized differently from most of the others. The word religion comes from roots meaning to bind together with logic or reason. Thus, I call what we have now by the term scientism, which is a very powerful force that in the pertinent area of origins and unfolding of the universe prevails over those based on sacred writings and mythology. But this popularly supported dominance doesn't make it right. The solution is, guess what? Intellectual responsibility.